Contrary to modern books, medieval manuscripts were usually filled with pictures. It's easy to imagine these illustrations to be something like this or this. But thumbing through these manuscripts could actually bring some unexpected results. You could find women laying eggs, or horses riding men, rabbits attacking people and then finishing them, suicidal wire walkers, and some scenes that are quite difficult to describe. A group of nuns picking some particular fruits. A little bit of medieval breakdancing, or a future Jedi Master. You can also find naked people playing instruments in an unconventional way, and naked people dancing in an unconventional way. But definitely there seems to be something recurring about snails. Not just people with snail shells, a lot of these are knights fighting snails. Nobody knows exactly what the meaning behind this surreal depiction is, but several explanations are available. There is a theory that it could be a representation of resurrection, or a way to remind the reader his own mortality, inspired by this passage of the Bible. Maybe it could be a way to portray enemies in a shameful way. Showing such an unbalanced fight could also be a way to do a commentary on social injustice. However, most probably, it's just some kind of medieval joke we will never fully understand. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun, and the second largest in the solar system. It has a characteristic that makes it the most visually unique: the massive rings. The planet formed billions of years ago, whereas regarding the age of the rings, there are different theories. One hypothesis is that the rings are remnants of a destroyed moon of Saturn, whose orbit decayed until it came close enough to be ripped apart by tidal forces. This would make the rings just hundreds of millions of years old. The second hypothesis is that the rings originated from the nebular material from which Saturn formed, making them as old as the planet itself. But what if Earth had the rings similar to the ones of Saturn? What would its skies look like? Illustrator and author Ron Miller created a series of pictures exploring this idea. In Washington, at 39 degrees from the equator, the rings would fill just a portion of the sky. Here, we arrived at the Tropic of Capricorn, at a latitude of 23 degrees. It's night, and in the same way as the moon, the rings would reflect sunlight. Exactly at the middle of the night, the Earth would cast a perfectly vertical shadow. Going south, the rings would appear bigger, higher in the sky, and stretching more towards east and west. This is how they would look like in Guatemala. At the equator, they would be completely sideways, appearing as a thin bright line, bisecting the sky. Here, the sun would align perfectly with the rings during the equinoxes in March and September. Finland. It is probably one of the most forward-thinking nations on the planet, and this emerges from various aspects of the organization of the country. For example, at the University of Turku, located here, it's possible to attend the world's first master degree course in future studies. It is part of the Finland Future Research Center, an organization that is devoted to the goal of creating a responsible and sustainable future. The Finnish government has instituted in 1993 a Committee for the Future. It serves as a think tank for the future impact of science and technology policy in Finland. This committee has to issue a report on long-term future problems and opportunities, to identify them at an early stage, in a way to mold and restructure policy lines way in advance. Finland is also hosting an underground nuclear waste storage facility that is the world's first built to secure the radiation for at least 100,000 years. The purpose of this storage is to isolate the nuclear waste from civilization in a totally passive way, during all the period in which this material is dangerous for humankind. Director Michael Madsen created in 2010 the documentary Into Eternity about this facility. It also explores the challenge to create a warning system around the area that will be comprehensible in 100,000 years, when most probably language and culture will have totally shifted. If you are curious about this particular topic, I suggest you also check out episode 114 of the podcast 99% Invisible. The Finnish language has no direct way to express the future tense. It has to use indirect forms. The economist Keith Chen proposed in a 2003 paper that because of this, the individual is more likely to plan for the future. Talking about the future and the present in a similar way helps making it more real,